GG.
Hi everyone, this is Chris from the Gallus Geeks. Welcome to my Let's Play series of Submerged, which is a fairly recent game. It's supposedly non-violent, or certainly advertises itself as no combat. As you can see, it's post-apocalyptic. The world has sunk under the waves, and you're playing the role of a young girl called Miku, whose brother, as you'll soon see, is not particularly well. And you've come to the city to find a remedy for his ailment. So, hope you'll enjoy it. It looks like a really beautiful game. I actually did start up a while ago, but I thought it was too good not to share with you all. So, let's explore this sunken world together. If that didn't sound too cheesy. I mean, look at that. That is beautiful, isn't it? I really quite like the stormy effect. Clouds in the sky and the wind rattling the palm trees. And I think that's us there. So I'm getting kind of like a... It's like a mix of cultures, the vibe that I'm getting. Sort of a mixture of Polynesian, South Asian, and Japanese cultures. Presumably at this point in history. We've got to carry on. Yeah, everyone's just kind of merged together. Ethnic lines are blurred, and Nigel Farage is probably dead. But furious, I'm sure his ghost is absolutely appalled. Well, that doesn't work. His wife's German. Politics. Let's leave it out of this, shall we? That is a nasty looking wound he's got in his stomach there. Is this... Oh, this is a cutscene. Oh, I like this. Storytelling without words. So, that looks like they live in a floating house, and... I'm assuming that's you there, the two smaller figures, and your mum and dad. Yeah, he's not just, like, ill. That is a proper wound. And telling me to look at our story. I need something to stop Tatu's bleeding. Tatu? Taku? It's actually quite small on my TV. Is there something around here we can use? Can I gather plants? No? Still, just look at this. Actually, I'm just going to pause the game for a second. Can I make optional graphics? Yeah, I think we might need to. Yep. Hopefully that, because I've just noticed a little bit of tearing. Is that any better? Ooh, what's that? Sounded kind of steamy. Am I imagining things? But yeah, there's definitely something around in the background. Maybe it's a whale? It's a blowhole? I mean, these are very much the tops of, like, skyscrapers, aren't they? I mean, just how sunken is the world? How deep is the water? I mean, you saw in that little tableau, and I'm not sure there is anything I can use here. You saw in that little tableau, like, they lived in a house on stilts. How tall are the stilts? Oh, wait, hang on, there's a waypoint. Oh, I need to get into my boat. Okay, let's hop on. Yes, Taku, I'm just going to abandon you for a bit. Be right back. Flag. It's an American flag, surely. I need to boat over and climb that building. Let's do that. And try not crash along the way. Whoa. Spectacular. I wonder if you can drift race in boats. Oh, look at that. That's a whale. Oh, that's so cool. Should we go over and have a look? Yeah, let's have a quick look. And there's a Ferris wheel in the distance. That is so gorgeous. I mean, to me, that was kind of the main appeal of the game. It just looked really nice. Oh, have I discovered things? I've discovered, like, a little flying fish pod. Let's have a look at that. Creatures. No, that was the thing about this game. It advertises itself as a non-combat game, but I'm pretty sure I've seen creatures that look kind of like swamp things. This is the Lyonnais Hotel, apparently. Knock knock. Anyone home? Apparently not. Alright, so... climbing. It's fairly straightforward. It's kind of... equal parts Assassin's Creed and... Did you ever play a game? Oh, well, way back when. Called Castilian. Kind of reminds me of that. I mean, back in the, like, early to mid-90s, I'm sure it was, like, an 80s game before. Alright. Is that a waypoint? Still up there. Right, let's look for other things to climb. I mean, I do like all the kind of scarred details. Is that a... there's a bit Mirror's Edge as well. I like that. That's good game design right there. Some people might call it handholding, but it's nice to kind of have indicators of where you're supposed to go. Those little red flower growths are quite natural. Oh god, is this going to be a balancing challenge? Can I walk off? Nope, can't walk off. I'm just going to tempt fate horribly, aren't I? What's this? The City Story. Oh, maybe you... Ah, so, like, you collect things and find out what happened, so... I'm going to assume that's, like, a hurricane or a typhoon. I'll keep these in my journal. I think I will. Ah, there's the whale again. You know what, later on I'm going to try and boat up to it just to see if I can get a bit more in my journal. Is this a bit that you can go down? It is, actually. Oh, hang on, I think that's a quick route down. No! Get back up there! Alright. There's more. Oh, yep. Again, that's quite cool. Like, the petals of the flowers are just dropping down, alerting you. There's that flag again. Am I supposed to tear bits off this to make a bandage? Let's further desecrate the flag. That's definitely, like, part of an American flag, isn't it? Red and white stripes. No, because I'm reasonably sure, I need to do some research, but one of the game sponsors, or the people mentioned in the production elements, is Screen Australia, which suggests to me that this is an Australian production. Nothing to stop it being set in America, of course, and I'm sure that looks like another boat over there, doesn't it? I wish you could zoom in. Can I zoom in? I'm pressing buttons, but nothing is happening. On the mission! Crates? Nope, empty crates. Door? Nope. Rusted shut, apparently. Oh, wait, that's the bit I came in. So I think I'm meant to go up here. Yeah, yep. Not a huge fan of this kind of sudden pulling out of the, ooh, sparkly thing. But yeah, I'm not a huge fan of that kind of pulling out of the camera. Because it just did a little bit jarring. But I suspect it's probably going to be necessary for future jumping puzzles. So, I shall reserve my judgment for now. And these appear to be actual crates. Let's bust one open and see what's in there. It's emergency aid. That seems like a thing that Taku needs. That's alright. Kind of automatically returns me. Well, I suspect that's probably just for this early part of the story. Does look like it's a kind of free roaming thing. There you go. Cover up that horrible gaping stomach wound. Just have another nap. Yeah, there's a more family story. So I'm assuming that's the dad, because he's got the... He looks more dad-ish. Oh, look, they've got a smaller fish. Or are they further off in the distance, Dougal? I'll be honest, he's still no looking well. Was he poisoned? Has he developed sepsis? I need to find more of those crates. I'm pretty sure we can do that. There's a thing on my marker. Yeah, he is not sounding particularly well, is he? Ooh, I can scout. Oh, that's cool. What was that? Well, it's a location, so... Oh, you know what? Let's get up somewhere high and see what we can see. So... Ooh, fireflies. Shiny. Right. That's quite a cool mechanic, actually. Could I jump up here? Whale! Whale! Mutant whale! Why are you glowing, whale? Yeah! Are those plants growing out of its head? That's mildly terrifying. But at least we have it. Landmarks? No landmarks. Where is that? Well, I know that the thing was over there. Right. Okay, so let's get closer. Let's pick it up. Oh, a boost. There better be some sweet, sick ramps in this. Alright, let's try a different hotel. So we've already been up the Hotel Lyonnais. Let's find another tall building. So that flat iron building over there looks promising. Well, I wonder, can I scout from here? Yeah, I can actually. There's something glinting at the top of that crane. Let's head towards that crane. It's kind of spooky at night. I mean, like, there's other things glinting over there. Yeah, spotted. What the hell is... Oh, it's the prow of my ship. Yeah, just panicking a little bit prematurely there. Can you blame me? There's mutant plant whales kicking around. Well, let's dock here. And up. And so there isn't like a sprint button in this, so you're actually going along at a reasonable pace. It's fairly leisurely. Who is it? More story. I like more story. And that's people. Okay, people in between skyscrapers? I'm sure that'll all fit together. Anything else that we can spot from here? Oop, there's a thing up there. Yeah, that's what I want. I have no idea what it is, but I want it. Ooh, and there's another thing. Ooh, actually. Yeah, let's go for that. Because, let's face it, I don't think Taku's long for this Earth. And, yeah. It would seem churlish not to aim for the medical crates, first off. So, could I get around there, actually? How do I get around? This way seems the more likely option. Sailing across the sea to be with my Uncle Sam. The music is really nice as well. It's just gentle piano. I think there's some glockenspiel type thing in there. Let's not whack the boat off things. There's another thing over there that we'll investigate later. But let's have a wander over there now, because I think that's... Oh wait, hang on, no, that's the crane. Oh, well, we're here. No. Right, there we go. And up. Ooh, there's another glinty thing over there. Oh, I've already scouted that. There's something... I think we need to be closer, maybe? Oh, no, that's the, Oh, hang on a minute. Oh, those are parachute shreds. That's what those are. So they must have airdropped, supply crates in. That's quite cool. You know what, this crane is going to be a fantastic vantage point as well. Let's see what we can add to our map up here. Oh my word, that's tall. Don't look down. Don't look down. I'm looking down. Okay, that's actually kind of cool. You know, like, it's still a little bit jarring, but it gives it a more cinematic feel than just kind of you wandering up a crane in third person. I like the way that was framed. That was nice. Just a cinematic experience. And oh my word. Look at that. That is just so nice. And there's another glinty thing in the distance. This game is going to make an absolute magpie out of me. As opposed to just the pie I normally am. Oh, I need to lose weight. But you don't want to hear that. Or do you? I don't know what you want to hear. Let me know in the comments. Oh, that's kind of cool. But is it the bird's eye? Is that a palm tree growing out of the counterweight? Oh, this is a landmark. That's kind of cool. Right, where am I? Oh, we switched to... Nope, thought we'd switch to first person there. Let's try not to fall off this. I'm sure it won't allow us to fall off, but... Let's not tempt fate. That would seem the thing to do. Let's have a look at what's over here. I think it's more story. It's people and a dog. So, yeah, are those birds coming in? Or clouds? Interesting. Now, if this were Assassin's Creed, we all know what we'd do here. But I don't see any piles of hay down there, so I'm, again, just not going to tempt fate. Oh, actually, no, let's do some scouting. Just so entranced. Ooh, there's multiple things. Oh, zoom in, that's what I want. So there's a thing over there. And there was something up here. Oh, that's another med crate, isn't it? Yeah, that's quite cool. Is that actually closer than the other one? And there's more story over there. Anything else? More story. Oops. There is a thing. Oh, it's another med crate. Oh, that's cool. Zoom out. Anything else right here? Not a glinty thing, or is it that? Nope, that's just a reflection. Anything else? You know, I think we're heading to that building next, because it looks fairly nearby. And over there. I think that's more story. Yep. Anything else? There's a shiny thing over there, but I think that might just be a map reflection. So I wonder if it just changes from day to night, like based on whether you've returned to Taku or not with aid. And I wonder if the environment changes, whether it's day or night. This is actually quite nice, like this, just seeing the plant life taking over after humanity has gone. I'm not gonna do my David Attenborough impression, because you definitely do not want to hear that. More stuff. Come on. You're scouting for things. Oop, there's a thing. Ah, there's multiple things. There's another story with lots of things. And there's another drop, isn't there? Yeah. Is it? Oh no, that's not a red drop. Interesting. Or maybe there's a... Oh no, that was the one that I already scouted, wasn't it? Oh, actually, that one does look closer. I think that might be it. Alright. Oop, did I spot a thing? Nope. Alright, let's go get those two story items and the... Oh, what's that? Flotsam. Okay. Yeah, let's go get those two story items and that med crate. So, from here is past the... rotundas, and is that north? Yeah, let's head north. Where am I? Okay. I quite like the fact that Miku is wearing a scarf that bills out behind. Ah, no! Oh god! Oh, think of the friction burns! That can't be good for you. Oh, right now! Like, if this was reality, surely, like, the ladder would be catching fire, Miku's skin would be burning off, and that right there would be a fatal collision. Oh, that was entertaining. Right, back in the boat. With our no hands. And let's head north, which is that direction. So, if we reverse out... I've learned all about boating in my Hong Kong days on Star Ferry. Totally haven't. Ooh, is that a thing? That's a thing! It's a plant manta ray. That is quite cool though. It's like a safari, but you get to look at things instead of killing them, which is the best kind of safari. Again, let's try not smack the boat off. It seems like not the thing to do. Right, can I even remember which building it was? Was this another landmark? The something creature, I can't read that from here. Ungulate? So they seem to have forgotten what horses are. It's rearing up in its back legs. Did it once have a rider? I guess we'll never know. Is that a tiny little palm tree growing out of its front hoof? Again, just nice touches. Right, let's get back to... Yeah, it's this building, isn't it? Let's dock here. Ooh, what's that? It's a little dolphin thing, isn't it? Oh wait, were those the first things that I saw? Yeah, I think that's what they were. Yeah, plant dolphins, not plant flying fish, as I thought they were. Because I wasn't paying attention, if I'm perfectly honest. Oh, we pop. No, what's this? Kitej Municipal Building. So is that what this city was called then? Kitej? Doesn't sound very American. In fact, it sounds slightly Uzbek. Oh, there's a drain pipe. Up we go. And... Oh wait, hang on. How high can we go? Actually, let's... Because I think this gets us to that story. Oh, but I can't actually jump up from there, can I? It was the red herring. No, I do not like herring. A bit of salmon, a bit of trout. That plant manta looked quite tasty. It's like a... Oh, I can shimmy along there. What the hell is that? I don't know if I want to go in there. Hello? Sir? Or ma'am? Are you going to eat me? Or otherwise be ghoulish and terrifying? I'm genuinely on edge now. Are those things coming from the sea? I'm pretty sure those are like sea monsters. And how far in the story does it come? Kind of towards the end, as I would imagine for a city. The sea monsters emerging from the sea would be towards the end. Let's clamber up here, shall we? I wonder if this takes me straight to the meds. Right. That looks like... That is the story. Let's shimmy along here. No. Up. Up and along. There we go. Where's the plant man? Did he just jump off the thing there? What if Taku's gonna turn into one of those plant people things? I can drop down here. Do I want to? I can get back to the drain pipe from there. That's cool. But what I want to do is nip around here, cross this board again. I'm so glad that it's not a balancing puzzle. I'm going to try and figure out a way to get around to that story, but apparently it's not that way. Is there something else that I have to climb up and then down? I suspect that might be it, actually. So, you know what? Let's get back to the drainpipe. Just remember that that is on the... I genuinely can't see my compass from here. I think that's the west side. Should probably point out, if I haven't already done so, that I'm playing this on my living room TV, so it's all the way over there, and not in front of my face like it would be on a computer monitor. Let's clamber up here. It's a platform I think we can jump on. And up. Shimmy. Or just leap across terrifyingly, why not? Yeah, here we go. And, oh, there's more story. Let's clamber up these petal things. Can I jump up there? No, but I can observe the loveliness of the city. I think they've actually created like their own language for this... this game. The most obvious thing is the written language and the spoken language, which, unless I'm completely insulting the existing culture by not recognizing their language. It's more story. Those are green waves. I think that's actually just the sea monster plant things just enveloping the city, which is nice. Right, I'm going to hold off... there's the drain pipe. So I'm going to hold off getting the meds for just now, because I think that'll automatically bring me back to Taku. I'm going to try and get the story over that way. Oh, there's a ledge there. It's kind of cool. Let's jump up here. And up here. Is there anything around? There are a bunch of flies. Which usually signifies, death, decay. I wonder what they're doing. Oh, wait, hang on. Can I jump up there? No? Can I run up there? No. What's the point of the flies then? Are they just there for flavour? But can I drop down here and get the other story bit that I saw? I think we can. Yes, here we go. Moonlight on the waves. Where does this fit in? That would appear to show the complete flooding of the earth. It's a nice, happy, jolly story, isn't it? But, if we're going to continue just destroying the earth, we should learn a lesson from these virtual people. Right, let's get back and head to that part of the courtyard to get more story. This doesn't look terrifying at all. No, I think I want to leap across like that. Pigeons! Are pigeons not considered worthy enough of inclusion in the creatures tab? It's just a pigeon. They're everywhere. Much as in the current present day world. Everywhere, and nobody really wants them. Which is a shame, because there's more flies. I don't know. Are they meant to signify anything? They are kind of clustered around these air vents, which are still going somehow. Oh, that's quite cool. The sun is shifting, isn't it? It appears to be doing so quite quickly. Are these flies swarming me? If I stand over here, or was I just... Okay, I do not understand the precession of this sun. Because it was going this way first, and then this way, and... I do not know. Right, we're going to leave the meds for now. Because I think if we... Or maybe it won't hold our hand and take us back to Taku, but I don't want to risk it without grabbing this story first. So let's drop down here and here, and let's slide down. Okay, you cannot. Clearly, those are bolted into the wall. You can't do that without like ripping your hands and feet off. I am such a plausible deniability. Not plausible, but suspension of disbelief Grinch, that's what I am. So that's, green waves. Oh, maybe they're not sea monsters, maybe it's just like walls of green water. Just kind of shallow water. I kind of want to know what comes in part 37. I think whoever came up with the idea of telling the story through abstract scribble drawings was pretty spot on. Excuse the sound of my sofa. Oops. And up. But yeah, it's just a really nice way of telling the story. It saves on translation costs. Right here. I actually just kind of want to see if there's anything else in the courtyard. That's where we started off, wasn't it? Right at the bottom there. And up the drain pipe. So I'm still completely spooked by that glowing plant man thing. Just kind of scuttled away. Is that what humanity's become now? Just glowing plant people. Right, well, we're here. Hang on. Is that beeping? Yeah, I think the transponder on that is beeping. Oop, there's a thing. What's over there? Is it a bolt upgrade? Possibly. Yeah, it's another boost. Which is why I want sick ramps to boost off. I just love seeing those panels ruffle in the wind, because clearly the weather has not kind of died down. And you know what? If there are storms in this, I will absolutely plots. There's a beacon over there, but I think it's too far away for us to note on our map. But it is right beside what appears to be the Brooklyn Bridge. So, to bear that in mind. I don't know if there's anything around here. Let's just walk thing for us to see. Oop, yep. There's a thing there. Probably story. Yep, by the looks of things. Hang out here. Scanning. Scanning around. Nope. And let's have Cookshafty over here. And then we'll grab the meds, because Taku's probably deteriorating fairly rapidly. Ooh, that looks like a shiny building. But there doesn't appear to be anything on it. I just wonder if that's because they're all inside or something. So there may be a point at which there's no longer anything left to spot on the map, but there's still things to discover. So you'll probably need to look in the buildings, actually, that don't have any visible shinies on them, which is quite cool. Well, I say it's quite cool. It might not happen. So, is this more medical stuff? Emergency rations. Ew, some sort of lighter. Ah, yeah, it is bringing us back to Taku automatically, isn't it? Alright, fair enough. It's the scary dude! Oh, you're covered in moss and lesions, isn't it? I bet it turns out to be, like, Miku and Taku's dad or something. Something freaky and weird and dramatic. Well, at least you can begin dying warm now, with light, to attract everything in the nearby vicinity. Ooh, more story. That's the mum. She's in her boat. Oh, she got lost in the storm. Oh, that's sad. You know, I genuinely feel for these kids now. Not that I was particularly unsympathetic to the child with the gash in his stomach. I need something for Taku to drink. I wonder if... So, I think the med crates just must kind of unlock whatever's needed next. But you know what? I think we'll just end this session here after the tragic drowning of Taku and Miku's mother out at sea. I think we'll just rescue a couple of these med crates every session. That sounds like a good plan. So we'll end it by the glow of the fire with the creepy moss monster watching us. And thanks for watching, guys, and we'll see you later on. I've been Chris from the Gallus Geeks, and this has been Let's Play Submerged. Cheerio! GG.